Hi guys! In this video, I want to take it back to the basics and how we manifest every single day of our lives. We manifest all the time. We manifest the good, the bad, and the ugly. So we can get into how you today can manifest your desires fast and so easily. So let's get into it. Hey y'all, so welcome back to my channel. All right, so if you didn't know, I'm gonna let you know right now, you are a powerful energy force. All of us human beings are. We are truly a spirit living in this body. We are not of the world, but we control our world, yes. We control our world. We are powerful co-creators, meaning that we co-create the reality that we are now living in today. Everything that is in your personal world, things that you like, things that you don't like, things that you wish would change, whatever the case may be, you did that. You did that. That can be like a lot of responsibility, and that can be heavy on some. Especially if you are dealing with something negative within your life. If you're dealing with lack of money, lack of respect, lack of relationships, whatever you're dealing with, that is because something that you controlled. It is something that you brought onto yourself, and it is something that you are doing within your reality. It could be a pattern, could be a habit, and you could be doing it subconsciously, but whatever it is, know that you have the control. You did that. Everything is up to your decision. You create your world. But if you are truly enlightened and you hear that, that's great news. That's good news. Because once you realize that you are in control, that's it. You created it, which means that you can stop it. You can switch it up. You can change the narrative. Like, I know I'm the divine person. I know I'm a divine being, and I believe in myself, because in myself I have the source. I'm connected to source. I'm connected to God's energy. I'm connected to the creator who creates it all. I'm a co-creator because I have to speak it. That's my part of creation, but the source makes it happen. The source is the omniscient and be making things divinely happen. I'm connected to that. Once I speak it and I believe it, my part is done. But I know the source that I'm connected to, they finish it off. I can tell you a personal story of mine and how I really came to realize that we are in control of our lives, that we truly manifest. When I first learned about law of attraction, I always kind of felt that it was something, but I didn't necessarily know what it was. But when I learned about the law of attraction, I was like, oh my gosh, that's what it is. Your beliefs truly make your reality. So I remember when I was in college, I had a funny relationship with money. A lot of my friends were struggling. My family was kind of not so great with money, or we were just coasting with money. It was never like ahead of the game, you know? So that was always my mentality. Up until my early 20s, I always thought, you know, money was not necessarily hard to come by, but it's, you know, you can't do that. You know, you're broke. You know, you can't really go shopping. Can't really go out to eat. Money's tight. Like, money was always tight. I remember that was just a natural thing. Like, that's just what it was without really any thought to it. It was because I had created a belief behind it without even really knowing, because of the friends, the environment I was in. You know, I was in college, everyone was kind of struggling, so I felt like, you know, it's okay to struggle, it's okay to be tight on money, you know, everyone is. And I had reasons as to why. You know, I'm in college, you know, I can't really have a job, whatever my reasons were, I can't really remember, but I remember I had reasons to back up my belief, so it was okay. But I remember when I came in tune with the law of attraction, and I was like, you know what, this trait is talking some knowledge. Like, that is true. If it is a belief and I can really change anything, changing my bank account was the first thing I did. So I remember that summer, I told myself, you know, at that time, I was living by myself. I was going to college, and my mom, like all my parents, were living in different states than the college I was attending. So I had to get in my own apartment so I could live and go to school and maintain. And at that time, I was a full-time student. I must have been part-time with work, but my bills were full-time, you know what I'm saying? So I couldn't pay all my bills at the time. And I remember my mom was helping me with, I think, probably up to 50% of my rent. And I remember having in my thought, you know what, like, that's not cute. My mom should not be paying a dime of anything that is for me. If anything, I should be giving my mom money. That is a belief that I quickly adapted when I learned about the law of attraction. And I gave myself a specific goal. I said at the end of May, it was 2013, because that was the year I graduated. It's like, at the end of this May, my mom's not gonna give me any more money. And if anything, I'm gonna be giving her money. Completely changed up my thought. And I truly don't know how it happened at that time. I don't know, maybe I was saving money. My whole pattern of my thought changed. My actions changed. My motive changed. My language changed. How I'm thinking about things. How I'm thinking about the now and how I'm thinking about the future. All of it changed because of that one thought I had. It was that one seed that I planted within my mind, and I started to make it grow. So because of that thought that I had, at the end of that May, my mother has not paid or helped me, gave me a dime since. And I'm so proud of that. I pride myself on that because, I mean, kids or people who are still getting financial help from their parents, don't shame it. Like, that's a blessing. That is a serious blessing to have. But at that time, I just personally thought it wasn't cute. So I changed my money relationship instantly. And today, what is this, 2020? Your girl ain't got no financial problems. We just gonna leave it at that. And yes, my mom is asking for us. Like, she doesn't ask for personal money. She helps, she's like my assistant when it comes to some of my bills. And she'd be like, all right, I need to write a check. So, you know, give me a check for the X amount of money because you owe X amount. I'm like, all right, yo. Whereas times if I owe money on a certain account that my mom was helping me with it, assisting, like acting as an assistant with it, telling me when the bill is due and X, Y, and Z, she would probably go ahead and pay it. She'd be like, okay, her bill's coming. I know she ain't got no money. I'm gonna go ahead and pay it. But now she's clearly calling me on the first, like, hey, I'm about to write this check, just so you know. Sometimes she don't even call me. She'll just send me a text like, hey, I'm writing a check for X amount. And it does hurt. Like, dang. Like, I just got the money in my account. But it's also a blessing. I'm grateful. I'm so grateful that I can do that because that was a goal that I had in my mind and manifested. So we have to understand that we are powerful beings. The words we speak, we give it life. But the words come from our thoughts. They come from what we already are thinking and what we truly believe. But when we speak them, we add action, we add momentum, and that makes us manifest even easier. So for example, if you're saying, you know, money is tight, money is expensive, or all I get is bills, or things, something always happens. That's like a classic one. Also, when it rains, it pours. These are affirmations which is going to be manifested in your life. Issue with your car comes in, it broke down, or an issue with your job, maybe you got let go, or an issue with your children, maybe they're off track. If that happens, because that just happened, it's not a negative thing nor a positive thing. It is something that happened. But if you already have the belief in your mind that, you know, when it rains, it pours, or something's always happening, you're automatically going to take that one situation and anticipate, prepare for the next negative thing to happen subconsciously. You might not be doing it on purpose, but you are doing it subconsciously because you took that one thing as a negative. You took being laid off as a negative, and now, you know, you're in the dumps, you're in the slumps. And when you stay in that mood, because we are powerful beings. But when you stay in that vibration, you're bringing in more of the negative vibration. You're bringing in more of the negative situations that can probably happen to you. I say all of that. I say my personal testimonies to let you guys know not to give up faith, to really be specific and in detail what you want and hold on to that, even when it's looking like it's a no. If that is a no, then be grateful. Say, cool, because I know that the next part, I know that the real one, the one that is for me, is dead on. It's going to be the ones especially just for me. So yes, guys, this is the first video of many to come, so I can show you that we are powerful beings and we manifest our life. This, I feel like, was just on the tip of the iceberg of how deep it really is into it, but I don't get to wrap in. But if you like this video, if it resonated with you, please go ahead and like and subscribe, and a lot more is to come. All right, y'all. Love and gratitude. All right, love and gratitude. Bye.